The problem of managing customers arises out of three main factors. They are behavioral, infrastructural, and communicative. The customer's behavior becomes problematic only as a reaction to the behavior of the staff member. It is only when the customer gets dissatisfactory, irresponsible, indifferent, or even arrogant response from the staff that he reacts in anger. A customer generally approaches a staff member to get a needed service. He does not have a predetermined idea that the service will not be rendered. In the case studies to be presented now, such common behavioral patterns which give rise to confrontation with the customers will be shown. Further, it is shown how change in the same pattern solves most of the problems. This leads to a stressless working environment all around and a very positive image for the postal department. The second factor is the infrastructural deficiency. These can be both within the same office or between offices. For example, erratic supply of forms, lack of cooperation among staff members, delay in transfer of accounts, etc., can lead to unsatisfactory customer service. In such instances, customers can be pacified by courteously and honestly telling them of the procedural compulsions. More importantly, responding in a responsible way, representing the entire department at that time, and not shifting the responsibility elsewhere helps. Usually, customers expect
committed response from the department persons.
The third factor that causes day-to-day problems is improper and insufficient communications with the customer. This can be easily eliminated by developing basic communication skills. Any communication must be clear, concise, complete, and pleasant.
Each case study will be in two parts. The first one will detail incidents that occur commonly, resulting in an angry, dissatisfied customer and a hassled, upset counter clerk. The second part will show the same incidents as it could have been managed by a clerk sensitive to customer care, resulting in a satisfied customer carrying an appreciative image of the postal department.
Hello, is this the post office?
Yes.
Can I send a 30 kg article by parcel post?
I'm not the inquiry clerk, I'm his friend. He is not in his seat. I'm waiting for him.
What? You are not the inquiry clerk? Can you connect me to the parcel counter?
I'm not from the department. You can dial to the parcel counter directly.
Hello.
Hello. Is this the parcel counter?
No.
Can I speak to somebody who can give me some information about parcels?
You ring up inquiry.
I have already called the inquiry. The inquiry clerk is not in his seat.
You can bring your parcel and book from here.
I will come anyway to the post office. Will you accept a 30 kg parcel? Damn it. He has already kept the phone down. Meena, get the parcel to the gate and stop an auto.
Yes, Daddy.
Can I send this package by parcel post?
Affix 60 rupees postal stamp and that should be sufficient.
It is nearly 30 kgs in weight.
I told you affix the stamps and take it to the parcel counter.
Oh, all right. Give me 60 rupees stamps.
I don't have change. Wait.
15 rupees stamps. Here is the change.
Here is the change and stamps.
I want to book this parcel. I have affixed stamps.
What is its weight?
30 kgs.
Parcels cannot be booked over 20 kgs weight.
What?
You should have inquired before bringing the parcel.
Damn it! I rang up. The inquiry clerk was not there. I rang up here. I was asked to come away. And now you tell me that I cannot book this parcel.
I am not responsible for your wrong thinking.
Nobody is responsible these days. You are supposed to serve the public. You don't even answer the phone properly. What are all you here for?
Why are you shouting? As per rules, the parcel should not be over 20 kgs in weight. You don't know and you blame me for your ignorance.
Don't talk of my ignorance. You people don't do your duty properly. You are so indifferent. I will show you how to do your duty. You have to book this.
In the first case study, the most common deficiencies in customer service have been shown. Almost all inquiries on telephone are dealt with abruptly and in an incomplete manner. Because of such defective service, the customer had to undertake a futile trip. Again, within the post office, customers are shunted from counter to counter. The inquiry clerk behaves as if the customer is disturbing his chat with a friend. He guides the customer wrongly by asking him to affix his stamps. The parcel clerk behaves in a totally unsympathetic manner. He blames the customer instead. No wonder the customer is wild with anger. Though the clerk is technically correct, as a human being, he falls short of ideal behavior.
What can you do for you, sir?
I have this packet to be sent by parcel post. Can you wait and tell me how much worth of stamps are required?
Can you tell me its approximate weight, sir?
About 30 kgs.
I am sorry, sir. Article should not weigh more than 20 kgs for parcel post. You could have inquired by phone before bringing it here.
I tried ringing up, but the phone was very busy.
Being an inquiry number, it is usually busy, sir. Now, let us see how we can solve your problem.
Oh yes, you have to help me out. I cannot take it all the way back. It has to be sent somehow.
What is in the packet, sir?
Books.
Then, I think we can make up two packets of 15 kgs each. You can get them repacked here only. The letter writer who is sitting outside, he will do the job for you. I will call him and instruct him.
Thank you very much. I was afraid that I will have to take it back all the way. Thank you again.
You are most welcome, sir.
Though the customer has committed the same mistake as before, the helpful guidance and sympathetic behavior of the inquiry clerk solves the problem. A ticklish situation was avoided by the quick thinking of the clerk. The customer went back a thoroughly happy person, as he saved himself from another long trip. Notice the way the clerk makes the flustered customer calm down. By using the pronoun we, he assures the customer that his problem will be taken care of.
I want to withdraw 500 rupees.
I don't have this account.
Yes, I have shifted from Pune recently. But it has been 3 months since I asked for transfer of my account to this place.
What can I do? It has not been transferred yet.
What do you mean by that? I have been advised by Pune Post Office people that it has been transferred long back.
The transfer advice may or may not have come. I do not know.
Then what do you know? It is my money. I want it now.
Give her good, sir. What do these people think of themselves?
When I am saying I do not know, it means I do not know and I cannot pay you.
I will see how you can refuse paying my money to me. I want my money right now. I will go and meet your postmaster.
In this incident, the behavior of the counter clerk is indifferent and confrontational. Here, though the transfer advice may have been received, it has not been posted in the AT register. This indicates a problem area within the office. The information given to the customer is vague and insufficient. It is also incomplete as the clerk does not inform the customer as to when the transfer advice will be posted and from when he can operate his account.
I want to withdraw 500 rupees.
I don't have this account.
Yes, I have shifted from Pune recently. But it has been 3 months since I asked for transfer of my savings account to this place.
Oh yes, sir. Sometimes the transfer advice is not sent to us immediately.
I have been advised by Pune Post Office people that it has been transferred long back.
Well, then it would have definitely been received by us. But probably due to pressure of work, it may not have been posted in my account register. Could you kindly come tomorrow, sir? I'll have it checked up and posted by then.
Can't you do it now?
Sir, as you noticed, there's a long queue behind you. And I cannot leave the counter and get it checked with my colleague right now. It takes time. Can you come tomorrow, please? I shall get the work done by tomorrow.
Okay. I may not be able to come tomorrow. I shall come the day after.
Oh, you're welcome, sir.
Thank you for your cooperation.
As you notice, the behavior of the counter clerk is sympathetic and responsible. She, as representative of the whole department, has taken up the responsibility to get the postings done by the next day. Her inability to do it at once is expressed in a courteous manner. While not trying to shift the blame by admitting the delay straight away, she gains the sympathy and thanks from the customer. Though the customer has not received the required service, he still went away in a satisfied frame of mind.
Sushila, you cannot go on grieving like this. Life has to go on. You have to set right your affairs.
Yes.
First, you have to get your funds together. You can start off with a post office savings bank.
Yes, but I've never been there.
Don't worry. I will go along with you.
Sir, this is my husband's SB passbook. He passed away recently. Do I get the money now?
Here. Let me look at it. Where are the other certificates?
What other certificates? I have brought the passbook. Isn't that enough?
But you require other certificates like death certificate, legal heir certificate, etc.
Nobody told me about these certificates.
I cannot do anything without them.
I am a lone woman. I can't come here again and again. Please, do something.
I have already told you I cannot do anything. How many times should I repeat this?
But...
No ifs and buts. You have to get these certificates. If not, you will not get any money.
But it is my husband's money. He deposited his hard-earned money here.
I have told you again and again to get these certificates. Now go away. Let the other people pay the deposits.
You're very prompt in taking our money, but not so prompt in paying back.
Another problem area is the indifference in dealing with settlement of debt claims. This is common to postal life insurance, savings bank, and national savings certificates. Here, the counter clerk has been very unhelpful. He should have realized that the customer does not know anything about the rules and regulations. He should have explained to her and helped her further by giving information as how to obtain the certificates. He should have written everything down and passed it on to the old lady who was helpless and bewildered. Instead, he again and again repeats about the non-production of the certificate, leaving the lady totally confused. Finally, he rudely tells her to go away. Naturally, she is bitter and sad.
Sir, this is my husband's SB passbook. He passed away recently. Do I get the money now?
Please give it. You are Sushila Devi?
Yes, yes.
You have to get some certificates like death certificate, legal heir certificate, etc. Your village sarpanch can guide you. Without these certificates, there will be a lot of delay. I think you require the money quickly.
I do not know what all certificates are needed.
Don't worry. I will write down everything. You give it to your village sarpanch. He will know what to do.
Thank you, young man. God bless you. I became frightened when you told me all sorts of certificates are needed.
It is our duty, Sushila Devi. Once you get these certificates, you will get your money in a few days.
God bless you. God bless you. Here, the counter clerk immediately understood the problem of the customer. He guessed that the customer was not very literate. He guided her to take the help of a village sarpanch for whom he wrote down all the details. Though the customer was not paid, at that point of time, she was still satisfied by the empathy shown by the counter clerk. She was particularly touched by the written information given to help her out. The customer gives her heartfelt blessings, as she felt relieved by the care shown by the counter clerk. The counter clerk added value to his duty-bound service by writing down the information fully and in detail to facilitate the settlement of a case quickly. His attitude in trying to help out another person in distress is very humane. Such humane touch would prevent most of the problems that arise in customer service.
See?
Yes, what do you want?
I have recently retired. I have received my PF amount. I want to keep the money in the post office. It is easily accessible. I understand the withdrawals are also easily done.
You can put the money in the savings bank.
But can I put the money in any other scheme?
I am in charge of savings bank. I can tell about savings bank only.
But if there are any...
Then why are you wasting my time? Do you want to put the money in the savings bank or not? It is very simple to operate.
Okay. If you say so, I will put the money in savings bank.
Here is the application form. Fill it up.
Hey, what type of person you are? You give me wrong advice and put me to loss?
What advice?
What advice? You are asking me? You made me put all my PF amounts in your savings bank where I get least interest?
You came to me and asked me. I told you to put it in savings bank.
But why did you not tell me about time deposits, monthly income scheme, certificates, etc.? I would have earned more interest.
You didn't ask me.
If I don't know, how can I ask you? It is only when my friend told me yesterday, I came to know about all the schemes.
Why didn't you ask your friend earlier, instead of blaming me?
All the blame is on you only. Being the postal department man, you should have told me about all your schemes and advised me how to invest my hard-earned money.
I'm not your financial advisor.
What the hell?
This case study pertains to that of an uncertain customer. Majority of the people are ignorant about the facilities available in a post office. Such lack of awareness creates an uncertainty in the mind of the customer. He expects the staff to inform him fully and guide him properly. Here, the clerk is neither interested in his duty nor the customer's need. He is totally indifferent whether the customer opens an account or not. Such indifference puts off potential customers. It also harms the image and business prospects of the department.
See?
Yes, sir. What do you want?
I have recently retired. I have received my PF amount. I want to put the money in the post office. It is easily accessible. I understand the withdrawals are also easily done.
It is nice of you to see the advantages of keeping money in post office. Sir, how will you be requiring your money back? In a lump sum, at a later date, or on a regular basis?
What are the schemes available?
We have got regular savings bank, but here the interest is low. As your amount will be large, you can go in for time deposits. Here, you get your amount after a set period of time. Same with the certificates also.
I may be wanting money on regular basis as I am retired.
Then you could opt for the monthly income scheme. You can get substantial monthly payments for your needs.
I think I shall go for this monthly income scheme. It suits my needs best.
I am glad that our monthly income scheme fulfills your requirements, sir.
Thank you for giving me such detailed information. You have helped me to invest my hard-earned money safely, properly.
Our customer satisfaction is our pleasure. You are always welcome, sir. Here is the application form for monthly income scheme, sir.
Thank you.
To every customer, his hard-earned money is very important. He desires to get maximum returns on his investment. Here, the counter clerk, by listing out all the available options, helps the customer take a right decision that suits his requirements best. The customer is naturally overjoyed and extremely grateful to the clerk.
In a service organization like the Postal Department, the values you should acquire become known to you the moment you put yourself in the customer's place. Your understanding grows regarding your duties. You further acquire the added commitment needed to render service tailored to the specific needs of the customers. To sum up, a positive modification of the factors that are usually causing problems in interacting with the customers will result in preventing most of them. This leads to a stressless and happier working environment. The staff member will be able to greatly increase his efficiency and productivity. Such a development, in turn, will result in solving the remaining problems, if any. In the final count, customer care is nothing but taking care of your own behavior and attitudes.